With a Windows Server domain controller, and depending on your environment, you may notice the Windows Defender firewall shows the public profile as being active. This behavior occurs with domain controllers running Windows Server 2025, 2022, or 2019 that typically do not have direct internet access. This is one of the few rare times in which it is necessary to actually log into a domain controller. A Windows computer's network connection is classified into one of three categories: public, private, or domain authenticated. Each category corresponds to a specific firewall and security profile. In Windows Server 2022 and earlier, the Network Location Awareness Service determines the network category. In Windows Server 2025, the Network List Service is now responsible for determining the network category, since the NLA service startup type now defaults to manual. On a domain controller, log in using domain or enterprise administrator credentials. Open the Windows Defender firewall with advanced security. In the overview section, observe whether public profile is marked as active. In Windows Server Core, in the sconfig utility, select 15 to exit. If using Windows Server 2019 or earlier, type PowerShell to enter PowerShell. Use the get-netconnectionprofile commandlet to check the network category. As with the Windows Defender Firewall GUI, the network category may appear as public. This behavior is typically prevalent in isolated environments that restrict direct internet access. For any domain join system, the domain profile should be active and the network category should reflect domain authenticated. This is especially critical for domain controllers. Using the set-netconnectionprofile commandlet to change the network category does not work, since domain authenticated requires proper domain discovery and secure channel verification. Mismatched profiles or incorrect network categories can lead to subtle, hard-to-troubleshoot issues, including failed domain replication, disrupted group policy processing, or blocked management traffic. The old documented fix for Windows Server 2022 and 2019 does not work for Windows Server 2025. A reliable workaround that works for all operating systems is to restart the network adapter that's connected to the domain. Although this sounds extreme and disruptive, it takes less than a second and can be scheduled to run at system startup. Log into a domain controller and open an administrative terminal. Use the get-netadapter commandlet to determine the correct adapter, especially if multiple are present. Note the adapter name and assign it to a variable. Use both the disable-netadapter and enable-netadapter commandlets appended as a single line. Be sure to include the -confirm $false option to suppress the interactive confirmation prompt. Type get-netconnectionprofile to verify the network category is now domain authenticated. Open Windows Defender Firewall to confirm that the domain profile is listed as active. This workaround is valid for the server's current uptime, but does not persist across reboots when manually invoked. To ensure reboot persistence, we'll create a scheduled task under the local system contacts that restarts the domain-connected adapter at startup, ensuring the network category is set to domain authenticated. Open Windows PowerShell ISE as an administrator. Configure the interface so you can use the script and terminal panes together. Create a short, simple PowerShell script to disable and enable the adapter. I'm saving the script in the C Program Data Scripts Task Scheduler folder. In the terminal pane, use the set-authenticate signature to digitally sign the script using your Enterprise CA, if possible. In the script location, right-click the script and select Properties. If signed, check the digital signature under the Digital Signatures tab. Under the Security tab, click Advanced. Click Disable Inheritance and select Convert Inherited Permissions to Explicit Permissions on this object. Click the User Group and Remove. Remove any other users or groups, leaving only System and Administrators. Apply changes, save, and close the Properties window. Close ISE. Open Task Scheduler. Right-click the Library folder, New Folder, and provide a meaningful name. Expand the library, right-click on the new folder, and select Create Task. Provide a meaningful name and descriptive details in the description box. Click Change User Groups, type System, and click OK. On the Triggers tab, create a new trigger. Begin the task at startup. In some cases, you may need to set the delay for 1 minute. On the Actions tab, click New. The program script field is the location of the PowerShell executable. The arguments field is the location of the script. If there are any spaces in the path, enclose the full path in quotes. On the Settings tab, set Stop the Task to 1 hour. Click OK to save, close Task Scheduler, and restart the domain controller. Log in. Open Windows Defender Firewall with Advanced Security. The domain profile is active. Open a PowerShell session. Type get-netconnectionprofile and notice the network category setting now reflects domain authenticated. For Windows Server 2022 and 2019 domain controllers, the old fix is simple. Log into a domain controller, open the registry with regedit. Navigate to hkey local machine, system, current control set, services, NLA SVC. Open the depend on service property and add DNS at the bottom. The letters DNS need to be uppercase. Note that the last line should be blank, but present. Click OK, exit the registry, and restart the domain controller. Log in and verify the domain profile is active in Windows Defender Firewall and that the network category now shows domain authenticated. This fix persists between reboots and can be considered permanent for the lifecycle of the OS. I hope you enjoyed this video, found it helpful and informative. If you have feedback, corrections, or suggestions, please share them in the comments below. Please like, subscribe, and share this video with others. Thank you for watching. I truly appreciate it.